I'm Tom Gingras, and I'm doing a sculpture of a fiddler on a roof. It's going to go on a music store on 35th Street in Austin, Texas. And I've got the fiddle built. I'm going to put bass strings on it to make it, the size will comply pretty nicely with the scale that I've done here for the violin. The figure is about 9 feet 6 inches tall. And when you're doing this sort of thing, you have to build from the ground up. I started with half-inch round bar and 3/8 round bar, and moved those materials through the form, especially aiming for the central axis, so that I did some put some meatier stuff going on in the middle, so that I could have more structure. Tending to go across occasionally, like this line here, which has become actually a front line in what I'm considering to be a vest on the figure. But it's also triangulating in the figure as we go. So adding to the structure all the time. Every time you add a piece of metal and welds, then you're making it stronger. I wanted to focus in today on a couple of things. I've got a place here that I did in the beginning, which I would like to cut. I don't like the location of it here. It's not the vest anymore. It's a part of the shirt, and I want to make the front of the shirt look like it's pulled out of his pants a little bit and kind of hang it in the front and moving with his dancing motion. And also, we're going to have a violin bow in this hand, and I've worked on it a little bit, built up, using the 3/8 round bar for most of it. I think I have one piece of half inch in here in the middle finger. But then I've got a couple places here where the thumb is too far back, and I've got too long a little finger here, and one other place on the outside where it's not the exact shape of the outside of the hand. So I want to show you how you can use the Cobra Torch, which I use exclusively now, the DHC-2000. And it's a fascinating machine to work with, and I've done a little bit of a modification on the cutting tip in order for you to see better how you can use it to both cut and weld with, so that you don't have to change the apparatus in order to make it work. I've got it right over here. Okay, I'm going to show you, these are the two cutting apparatus that come with the Cobra Torch. They're $49 a piece if you buy them separately, but they come with the torch setup, the standard torch setup. I'm going to be using this one here, which is the one that goes underneath the gun. I've got the gun shown here with the apparatus on it, and I'm going to show you the way the normal cutting attachment goes and the way it sits in relationship to the cutting, the torch head that's doing the torch tip, that's doing the heating. And I'll just finger tighten it, and you can see that relationship as it sits. So what I've done is I've cut off the first quarter inch of the torch tip, the cutting attachment, which is a copper tip, and I set it up this way. So it's a little fatter, but it sits really just a little bit behind the heating tip. All right, so we've got a relationship there now where it's almost in the same plane. Okay, and I'll show you in a minute how to use that. Okay, I'm gonna cut this part of the hand here and make this go in a little bit more so that it's got a little bit less wrist width in this place. It's gonna require that I cut here, and then I'm gonna heat back here and bend this in at the same time. Okay, so I'm gonna light the torch. Light the acetylene first, and then the oxygen, get it burning clean. Add oxygen in. I get a balance flame first. I'm going to add a little bit more to it, get some heat there, and then I depress the lever, cutting lever, and I adjust the oxygen flame. Actually, I'm going to use the oven. There we go. so that it doesn't change shape when you depress the lever. I'm going to heat. And I'm going to try to cut so that I don't cut into the 3/8 bar that's here up above the torch tip. Okay, it's going to take a minute for it to get to the molten temperature, but I want to wait till I have a good molten pool on there, a good thick one, before I start the cutting, because that way I'm ensured that the heat has wrapped all the way around and that I've got enough heat to cut all the way through the piece. All right, there's a good melt on there. I've got a good thick puddle. And then I depress and get glued in. And I can just cut it away like that. Just give a second. And then I'll put the heat on here, grab my pliers. And notice that if I shoot the heat on one of these at the right angle, I can shoot the heat on the back one as well. So I'll just kind of wash the heat on in this place, get it a little bit orange. Starting to color up a little bit now. One of the amazing things about this torch is how quickly it heats the metal. Part of the you save about a third of the amount of gas that you would normally use by using the Cobra Torch. And this is, I'm sure, one of the savings that in the process is how quickly it heats the metal up. Here we have both pieces, cherry red, or a little bit more than that, a little more orange. And I want to increase the length of the heat, not heating my pliers. Increase the length and make it a gradual curve. And that looks pretty good. I can blow some of this slag off of here. I might as well take this end off where it's real crispy metal. And then pinch it with my pliers if I can. Can't quite get to it from here. Close enough. I'll grab a welding rod and I'll make a bridge across this. I want this one to be inside this as though this is a part of the sleeve and it sticks out a little bit beyond. This part sticks out beyond the hand. And I'll just color this up. I'm going to change the settings so I've got a little bit more acetylene. And it's where the heat is generated, is in the heat, in the acetylene. I'm going to build a drop, push it to the back, build another drop, push it to the back, build another drop. Keep going like that until I actually can bridge up to the 1/8-inch rod that crosses at the wrist. Get it molten on here. Still bridging, still building. While I'm heating, I can still continue to weld if I use the edge of that torch, or the cone, on the torch tip. I'm filling it out to full width, and then I'll go back and sculpt it down, again using the edge of the torch, or the edge of the cone. I'll push this stuff to the back, and get that so that it is out of the way, and then I'll pick that up from behind after I'm done with the shoot. Okay, sculpt it out, and get it clean. And one of the fascinating things about this as an art form is that you can actually sculpt the molten metal. So it returns us to a place like when we're working with clay, where we can actually move the clay around with our fingers. If we've got enough pressure, I use 7 on the acetylene and 14 on the oxygen, and it gives us enough pressure to be able to maneuver the metal. Okay, so you can really sculpt with a sculpting torch. Thank you.